up, Candy? This is Stephanie Dupuy with Dupuy Team at Keller Williams West Sound in Silverdale, and
I am Cassandra Lopez with Dupuy Team at Keller Williams West Sound in Silverdale.
Yes, and today we're going to talk to you about, it's a seller's market. Buyers are still inspecting homes, thank goodness. So if you're a buyer and you find something wrong with the house, which you will if your inspector, you know, is doing their job, what do you ask for and what don't you ask for? How do you make this decision? Because we're seeing some buyers, basically they're their own worst enemy.
They are.
Yeah, you need a house right now. So don't shoot yourself in the foot. Before we get to that today, Kids Up Candy with the pocket stats, housing stats, not much change. Literally same amount of listings for the most part that came on market this week.
Down by 8.
Yeah, the inventory is the same for residential and condo. We're just down a few for residential. So not much to report here. Sales price to list price, still right around list price. So if you're a buyer, last week we're at 100.8% of list price. This week we're just below list price. And I would consider that if I was a buyer, make full price offers.
Yeah.
It really is.
This could be like closing costs for one transaction for the entire MLS last week.
Yes.
Like that's nothing.
It is. It's statistically irrelevant because there's so few sales, essentially. So average prices are still high. So that's our stats in a snapshot.
Yep.
So let's go to
It'll be in the comments if you want to
read if you want details.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So inspections.
Inspections.
We're representing quite a few of both sellers and buyers right now. So we're seeing both sides of this. What do you think is the number one thing that buyers are doing to be their own worst enemy?
Buyers are asking for a laundry list of items on what we call the inspection response. So this is you get your inspection report from your inspector, you choose the items you want the seller to address, and you write them on the inspection response and deliver it to the seller. And we're seeing some really easy, basic homeowner maintenance type stuff that the buyer can handle after closing.
Yeah, so rule number one with inspections, when you get your house inspected as a buyer, the inspector's job is to find things, and they're gonna
even on new construction they will find things.
Exactly. And so they're gonna have a ton of items listed on the inspection response. Those aren't things that you necessarily ask for. Those are simply for your information. Yep. Our rule, what I explain to buyers, is ask only for deal breakers.
Yep. Deal breakers and appraisal concerns.
Yeah, so everyone's different. We talk about appraisal concerns because I have another philosophy on that. But most people do ask for appraisal concerns, and sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. So
hopefully the seller's listing agent has coached them and advised them to handle any appraisal concerns up front before the home even goes on the market.
Yeah.
So there'll be minimal ones anyway.
We make sure that they're done. We might not address them in the 35R.
Mm-hmm.
We ask for only deal breakers.
Yep.
Non-negotiables. Why wouldn't you ask for something that's not a non-negotiable if you're a buyer?
Because the seller doesn't have to agree to any of it. And
it's just a request.
It's just a request. You're not demanding, and
you have no legal right to demand.
It's another form of negotiation where buyer and seller have to agree on all terms.
Mm-hmm.
So if you ask for something that's not a non-negotiable, like change the GFCI outlet in the kitchen, that buyer could do after closing, in 5 minutes.
Can I tell you one that came up this week?
Well, let me just finish my sentence. So the seller can say no, and the deal can fall apart over a GFCI. It's the dumbest thing in the whole world. You just beat out 8 other buyers for this house, and you're willing to lose the house over something trivial. Because a lot of buyers aren't, like, they're not homeowners. They don't know what it takes to do homeowner maintenance. They think it's like a big deal.
Here's what happens. This is what we see, and it's just painful to watch this go down. It's painful.
It's painful.
This buyer has been looking for houses for months.
Yep.
They can't find a house. They finally get one under contract. If you get a house under contract, don't mess it up. Keep it. So then they do the inspection, and the inspector says there's no GFCI in the kitchen by the water source, and this is an electrical hazard. Yes, technically it is. And the buyer says, well, I'm not buying the house until the electrical hazard is corrected. Buyer, just our perspective is, you just spent 2 months looking for a house. Mm-hmm. You've looked at 100,000 houses and you've put in 20 offers. Don't lose this house over a GFCI. It's a $15 to $20 part at Lowe's. It'll cost you $75 to hire a licensed electrician to put it in yourself. Don't lose the house over a $75 professionally installed situation.
Yep.
That's not worth it. That's just called, what's that called? Illogic?
Unrealistic.
Unrealistic. Yeah. The seller's going to say, get real. Yeah. The house you're living in probably doesn't have a GFCI.
And you know what?
In the kitchen that you're living in right now. The apartment you're in is a bigger electrical hazard than this house you're buying.
And your seller probably has somebody in backup.
Or five.
Or five people in backup.
Yeah.
They're just waiting for you to fall out so they can go to the next.
It's hard.
Yeah.
And we're seeing buyers do things like that.
Yep.
You're not special just because you got it under contract, and you're not special because of a GFCI.
It's because you delivered the seller the most favorable terms, and the seller liked it, so you guys agreed. Cool. Contract.
Exactly. Yep.
So now when you get to the inspection
phase. So what do you do? If a buyer sees GFCI on
there
and they don't understand. Let's say I'm a buyer. I've never owned a home before, and I see a GFCI. This is an electrical hazard.
Yeah.
And now I'm scared to death. What do I do?
You know what? I know.
And my parents are telling me, I bought a house in 1967 for $50,000, and there were no problems with the house. It was perfect. I'm getting ripped off, and my agent, all they want to do is sell me a house. They don't care
about
me.
Good for your parents.
What do I do?
Good for your parents.
What do I do if I'm like 25 years old or 35 and that's my situation? How do I handle this?
Google it. What does it take to replace the GFCI?
GTS. Google that shit.
Yeah, because you'll find a YouTube video that's like 5 minutes long, how to replace one.
Yeah.
And we spend a lot of our negotiating time with the buyers, talking them off the ledge for small stuff like this that they think is like overwhelmingly complicated. Mm-hmm. They're super duper simple.
It's rare to have a house inspected where all the GFCIs are in the house.
Or working.
Yeah. Ungrounded outlets is common.
Yep.
So also you can call the inspector.
Yeah.
And ask the inspector.
Yeah, that's a good one. They like to talk to you guys.
Yeah.
So
that's just
And when Steph said deal breakers earlier, deal breakers are subjective to you.
Mm-hmm.
So if a failing roof is a deal breaker for you, then that's what you would ask the seller for.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're talking expensive items, high end items that if you were to purchase the house, it would become a money pit. That's what we're trying to avoid for you.
Mm-hmm.
But we would be able to coach you on what we think deal breakers would be, and then also appraisal concerns.
Yes, exactly.
So,
right? Thank you.
Thank you.
If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. If you enjoyed this, please share this with your friends. Like this, like our Facebook page, subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yeah.
And we will see you next week. I am Stephanie Dupuy with Dupuy Team at Keller Williams, West Sound.
Cassandra Lopez, Dupuy Team, Keller Williams, West Sound. And if you guys have a topic you want us to cover, put it in the comments below and we'll definitely research that.
Yeah, we enjoy this. We do a little brainstorming every week with topics. So we'd like to hear what you guys like to see.
Yep.
We look forward to seeing you next week.